Here they are for one and all. The Moomins are about to call. Come on and sit down here with me. They're here for you on your TV. They are the Moomins. They are the Moomins. So come with me, give me your hand. I'll take you up to Moomin Land. You can fly just like a bird and sing the best song ever heard. There with the Moomins. 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 Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 ba.
Now, it's very nice to get letters, at least every now and then. However, in Moomin Valley, they're rarely sent or received. And yet they do have letterboxes, and even postmen.
Oh-ho! Moomin!
Hello? Is that for me?
A letter for the Moomins.
He's gonna fall in this time.
What?
Come on. This way. Towards me. Come on. Come on.
Oh!
I got him!
Did you dig that hole?
Yeah, and it worked, didn't it?
All right, who's responsible for this?
Are you all right?
Did you dig this hole, young Moomin?
Of course not.
Who was it then? Hi, you! I should have known! Come here, you just wait!
Hold on, Mr. Postman! Can I have my letter, please?
Just you wait!
Here's a letter, Mama.
Hmm? Oh, goodness, a letter.
I think it's from Mumble.
Oh, really? Where's little Mai, Moomin?
Well, she's,
So, who's this letter from? It's from my sister Mumble, isn't it?
How should I know?
She went on holiday to get away from me. I bet she's coming back because she's missed all the fun.
She'd stay away if she has any sense. This is the third time I've fallen into a hole.
Yes, I know. But this is only the first time I've seen you do it.
What a horrible little child you are.
Aren't I? Whoop! Whoop, that was close.
Go on, fall off. Come here, wait till I get my hands on you.
Mumble says that she's coming back. She feels that she's ready to cope with little Mai again.
Oh, that's good news, Moomin Mama.
I think that we should go and give her house a good clean.
Have you told little Mai? Now Mumble's coming, she'll be able to go home.
No, I expect the postman is still chasing her around the garden.
Don't tell me why. I don't want to know.
Mama! Mama! Is the letter from Mumble? What does she have to say? Is she coming home?
And a few days later, Mumble returned to Moomin Valley. Now, Mumble is a lot bigger and prettier than little Mai. And what's more, she's a lot quieter.
That's Moomin Valley, over there.
It's not full of creepy crawlies, is it?
Not as far as I know.
Is there a house over there?
Maybe they'll have food. Let's go.
Oh, that's Moomin House. Are you going to Moomin Valley, too?
Yes, we thought we would.
That's nice. So am I. We can go together. Your suitcase looks very heavy. Would you like a hand with it?
No!
Oh.
Okay.
Are they nice, the people that live in that house?
Yes, they are.
Could we stay there?
I'm sure you can. My little sister is staying with them. Follow me. I know the way. Shall we go? What's the matter?
Nothing. We'll follow you.
All right. Oh, by the way, I met two very small strangers who said they were coming here.
Coming here, Mumble?
Yes, they're both the same size as little Mai. Both a bit odd, and they're carrying a very large suitcase.
Right, I'd better make them up a small double bed, then.
Thanks for the tea. Now, are you ready to come home with me now, little Mai?
No, not yet.
We've got to go home and tidy the house. It hasn't been aired for the whole winter.
It's all right, Mumble. I cleaned and swept the floors the other day and opened all the doors and windows.
Thank you very much. It must have been a relief to be asleep most of the time little Mai's been staying with you.
They said they haven't been bored once since we woke up, and we've had a really good time together. Isn't that right, Moomin?
Bye-bye now.
Well, well.
What does well, well mean, Papa?
Just that I might be able to hear myself think again now.
I know what you mean.
You knock, Thingamy.
No, it's your turn to be brave. What if they scream when they see us?
But the lady told us they were friendly, Thingamy.
Excuse me. Now, what's the matter with you two? Don't forget your suitcase, will you?
What can we do?
It's all right. Don't be frightened. I won't eat you. I'm the police inspector here. Been in the valley for years.
Police?
Oh, no! Oh, no! We're not thieves! We didn't steal what's in the suitcase!
No, we didn't do anything!
No.
Well, nobody said that you did.
Then you haven't come to arrest us, have you?
Of course I haven't. I've come to see the Moomin family.
It is our suitcase!
It is.
Of course it is. Now, have you come to see the Moomins, too?
Hello. Oh, there you are. I thought it was you.
Are you expecting these two guests, Moomin Mama?
I think so. And they've got a suitcase, so they must be staying. That's nice. You will stay, won't you?
If it's all right with you.
Of course it is. I'm Moomin Mama.
And this is my friend Bob Moomin Mama.
You're welcome. Come in and make yourselves at home.
I think it'll be okay, Thingamy.
Careful! We mustn't drive in a hurry!
They are a bit strange, aren't they?
Yes, definitely.
So, what can I do for you today, Inspector?
Oh, well, I heard that Mumble was back from holiday, so...
Yes, that's right.
Oh. Is she here now?
No, Inspector. I'm afraid she's gone home with little Mai.
Oh, right. I have to keep an eye on things, you know. Very important. Who goes away? Who comes back? Well, I'll say goodbye then, Moomin Mama.
I do believe he's fallen for Mumble.
But has she fallen for him?
I wonder.
What are the new guests doing?
Looking scared, mostly.
Here you are. I've emptied these drawers for you. There should be enough room.
Thank you, Moomin.
Where should we put this suitcase?
Let's see. In this drawer? That'd be a good place to hide, too.
Oh, look at this. They've made such a pretty bed for us.
Moomins. They didn't scream at all.
We still gotta be careful, though. Oh.
We've had some very strange people staying at our house, but I think these two are really weird.
Well, they're northerners.
I guess so, with names like Thingamy and Bob.
And that suitcase.
They look a lot like fugitives to me, Snufkin.
And perhaps they're dangerous criminals, on the run.
Do you want to see them?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind, Moomin.
What are they doing now?
No idea. I couldn't hear anything, so they must be asleep.
We think they're fugitives, Moomin Papa. They're probably on the run from the law.
Well, they are a bit funny about their suitcase.
Gold coins.
Stolen state secrets.
Arsonists. We'd better hide all the matches, Papa.
Public enemies numbers 1 and 2, but they don't look like it, though.
How about some tea, Snufkin? Sniff?
Yes, please.
Any cakes as well?
What on earth are you doing under the bed?
It's the safest place.
Something's about to happen, Thingamy. I can feel her coming. That's what woke me up.
Don't be silly. She can't know we're here.
She can, and I know she'll be here tonight.
It's very windy tonight, Moomin.
And chilly, too, don't you think?
Oh, hello. Did you sleep well? Would you like some tea?
Hey, so that's them.
Don't worry. These are good friends of mine. Let me introduce you. Sniff and Snufkin.
What's the matter?
She's coming!
Yes, she is.
Well, who is, my dears?
The Grook.
The Grook?
Yes, she's terrible.
Who? You know who she is?
Yes. I've never seen her, but I've heard she's a scary monster, all right.
Scary monster?
And this, Groke is after you.
Yes, she is!
Now, don't you worry. She'll think twice before she tangles with me.
Will she?
But if she's a scary monster...
Monster or not, if you're a guest in Moomin House, nothing will harm you. Right, everyone, lock all the doors and you two go to your room.
Thank you, Moomin Papa.
Nobody is going to get in here.
Well said.
To arms, family, to arms.
Ready for more tea, anyone? What's the matter?
We're going to be attacked by a huge, scary monster.
Heavens!
You'd better get the frying pan, Mama.
Oh, dear.
Ah, right. Has everyone got a weapon, huh? Well, it's midnight.
I don't believe in that stupid Groke.
I hope you're right.
She's coming! She's here!
Yeah, she's very close now.
Going home. This is silly. We can't wait up all night. Besides, I'm getting very sleepy.
It's up to you.
Right, I'm going then, Moomin Papa.
Watch your back.
Yes, keep in the open.
You guys are only trying to frighten me. Well, it won't work.
She's here.
No, she's not. There are no such things as monsters. Just a draft blowing the candles out.
You see? There's nobody there.
Well, in that case, there's nothing to stop you going home, Sniff.
Do you think I'm scared? You're making it up. Come on, admit it. There aren't any Grokes. None at all. You see? There's no one here at all.
Careful, watch what you're doing.
It's here! It's here!
Where?
Right outside that door! Big and black and horrible!
Right.
No, don't open it! She'll get in!
Come on, everybody. Well, there's nobody here, Sniff.
Are you sure? I can't see anything. Oh, I must have scared that silly old Groke away, Moomin. That'll teach her to come sniffing around here, all
Look,
right.
There she is.
Wah!
Mrs. Groke, we'd like you to go home. Now, you just go on. You're upsetting our guests.
And you're freezing my roses.
Yes, you big bully.
I'm sorry, but you really must leave. Please go before I count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 and a half.
Hey, are you all right, Moomin?
Look at the ground.
It's all frozen.
I'll be back! I'll be back!
That's the Groke's voice.
Oh, it's cold.
Isn't it?
I don't think she'll be back tonight.
Let's all go in and have a hot drink.
The Groke didn't come back that night. But what did she want in Moomin House? And will she return perhaps another night when they're all asleep?
They love the laughter and they love the living, the Moomins. Believing is sharing and caring and giving, the Moomins. They're always happy and always at play. The Moomins are having fun day after day. The Moomins, the Moomins. They love the laughter and they love the living. The Moomins, believing and sharing and caring and giving. The They're always happy and always at play. The Moomins are having fun day after day. The Moomins.